I'm Bedri Baykam.
Hi, this is Philip Tsiaras.
No, I'm Philip Tsiaras.
And this is Bedri Baykam.
It's the open-mindedness, which is what this project is all about. The collaboration shows that you can be open-minded enough to do this, and the concept of the exhibition means that the cultures that we are involving have to be open-minded enough to think about this. The idea of working with one Turkish artist and one subject where we could integrate the subject together, different styles, different cultures, cultures that have complexities and difficulties, it would be something of interest to all levels of people. So this is a project that has a political, moral, cultural significance that any person could think about. Horses for Peace, the equestrian, the horse is a great symbol for both Turkish and Greek cultures. The Mediterranean has the horse, is a great icon for so many things. And the horse is also a naive being. It is without politics and it is without guile. It's like, of all the animals, it's the most muscular and somehow the kindest. A little fly can make a jump.
Strongest but intuitive.
Also.
Charming. Very, very close to the human. Yet it's not a pet like a cat or a dog. But in a way it's very distant, but it's very close. It's very independent. But it's very reliable.
Yes, it's independent, but it's also harnessed by society. Both of us, in effect, are informal painters. In other words, we are not strict formalist painters. But one of the things about doing a collaboration is that it's important your style be there, in the sense your signature be there, but it's also important to step back and see if you can enter another head to make a new painting. And that's always the challenge. Not to always necessarily, you know, want to stain the territory, you know, with your signature, because then you'll be making the same painting forever.
We pour a common energy in this painting. Now, when we say horses for peace, it's mainly these paintings done in collaboration. It doesn't mean that symbolically we are doing paintings that will show nice horses always kissing each other and looking to the... We are not doing symbolic works on that regards. It's the general iconography of the horse that we've been telling you about, and it's the common energy we pour into the painting, which can be very colorful, warlike, ecstasy-like. That doesn't matter. We're not trying to make a symbolic, you know, mishimashi image of...
That's true.
When you look at the finished painting, you can see that he was there, that I was there, and you can also see that we were there. And you would look at this painting and you would know that without him being there, without me being there, this painting would never have been born. It's a specific fruit of both of us.
Wouldn't it be nice also to say that you would also like to make a painting like that yourself? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's the thing that I'm saying.
Sure.
You know, that's the learning part.
Yeah.
You make a painting that's really also yours but with somebody else, but the next painting that you make by yourself, you can say, you know, I wouldn't mind making a painting like that because I wouldn't have done that on my own had I not done it. That's the thing, you know, that as an artist you can get.
When we look at the final painting, for us to sign it, it has to satisfy us. It's visual, it's compositional, it's content-wise, color-wise, intuition-wise. So the painting speaks to us at a certain moment and starts saying, okay, I'm finished. You can, you know, give me the last caresses. Να κρατηθώ
Δώσ' μου ένα όραμα να αντισταθώ.